Hi my dear friends, today we will discuss in this video presentation primary angle closure glaucoma. Glaucoma is a group of irreversible progressive optic neuropathies that can lead to severe visual field loss and blindness. It may be primary or secondary. In primary glaucoma, the elevation of the intraocular pressure is not associated with any other ocular disorder. While in secondary glaucoma, there is a recognizable ocular or non-ocular disorder which interferes with aqueous outflow. In terms, this will lead to elevation of the intraocular pressure. Primary angle closure glaucoma, which is our topic today. Classification of primary angle closure glaucoma. Based on the mechanism of angle closure, there are two forms of primary angle closure glaucoma. The first is pupillary block, the second is plateau iris syndrome. Anatomical predisposition for pupillary block include short axial lens eye, like this photo. This short axial lens eye will lead to crowding of the ocular structures and will make the lens in a large size in relation to the other ocular structures, and this will cause pushing of the iris forward to some degree, causing shallow anterior chamber like this photo, as we can notice this by slit lamp beam. There is a shallow distance between the cornea and the iris and causes convex iris lens defect. All these causes will lead to a high liability for pupillary block. Pupil block faced by physiological pupillary block caused by short eye and shallow anterior chamber. So the passage of aqueous from the posterior chamber to anterior chamber occurs with some degree of difficulty, like in this form. In a condition which causes dilatation of the pupil, crowding of the iris will occur at the angle of the anterior chamber, and this will increase the difficult drainage of aqueous through the angle. This will cause accumulation of the aqueous in the posterior chamber and will push the iris forward, and this will lead to what is called iris bombay. The iris bombay will increase gradually and total closure of the angle will occur, and very high rise in the IOB will occur. Classification of primary angle closure glaucoma with pupillary block mechanism can be divided into different stages. However, there is some degree of overlapping between these stages. The stages include latent type, subacute or what's called intermittent type, acute congestive type, chronic type, and lastly absolute stage, which occur when there is a total optic atrophy and loss of vision. Latent angle closure glaucoma, it is an early stage of the disease and characterized by anatomically predisposed eye with short eye, shallow anterior chamber, and high liability for angle closure. The diagnosis here done mainly by slit lamp biomicroscopy without manifestations. The patient doesn't complain. When we do gonioscopy, we will notice that there is some degree of angle closure or what's called occludable angle. Here, the treatment done prophylactically by peripheral YAG laser iodotomy to make the aqueous passes from the posterior chamber to the anterior chamber easily and equalize pressure at both sides, making the iris movement less common. Intermittent angle closure. It is the stage for the occurrence of acute congestive glaucoma, in which the pupil is dilated for many reasons, especially as in cases of dim light. When the pupil becomes dilated, the angle is occluded by the peripheral iris and the drainage of aqueous is obstructed and the rise of IOB occurs. This will lead to some degree of corneal edema and separation with complaint of drop of vision. When the pupil becomes myotic again, the angle will open and the pressure will decrease and the corneal edema will disappear, and here the patient returned to his normal state. During the attack, we can notice the presence of obscure edema due to rise of the IOB and closure of the end. Treatment of the intermittent attacks of ankle closure is done by also by prophylactic bilateral peripheral YAG laser algorithm like this foot. If the patient of intermittent ankle closure glaucoma attack is not resolved, if the attack of intermittent ankle closure glaucoma is not improved, the patient will pass through acute congestive ankle closure glaucoma with high rise of the IOB and no improvement of drainage of aqueous. The main complaint here is severe ocular pain, mainly ocular and periocular pain and head. The second symptom is red eye, the third is marked drop of vision. Signs we can notice in examination: severe corneal edema due to very high IOB, dilated inactive vertically oval pupil, shallow anterior chamber with ciliary injection due to very high rise of the intraocular pressure. And if we can examine the angle by gonioscopy due to severe corneal edema, we will notice complete angle closure. In this photo, we can notice that the severe corneal edema with shallow anterior chamber and here the ciliary injection of the congestive glaucoma together with mid-dilated fixed pupil caused by acute congestive glaucoma. The main treatment of acute congestive ankle closure glaucoma by measures which decreases intraocular pressure, which include acetazolamide orally or systemically by intravenous injection. The second is hyperosmotic agents like mannitol or oral glycerol, topical therapy which include meiotic, beta blockers and steroids. Weak steroids here to decrease the ciliary injection, beta blockers to decrease IOB, and here meiotic to causes meiosis of the pupil and opening the angle again. But here we should notice that meiotics only work on non-ischemic IOB muscle. So we should wait until the IOB decreases by the effect of meiotic diuretic and start to give the patient topical bilocarbine or topical meiotic. After the IOB is controlled, we can do YAG laser iridotomy to both eyes when the cornea is clear. But here we should notice that the angle should about more than 180 degrees open. If closed more than 180 degrees, we should do trabec electomy. Chronic angle closure glaucoma. The features of chronic angle closure glaucoma is similar to primary open angle glaucoma. In both types, there is an visual feature change and optic disc changes, and the patient here doesn't complain of signs of acute congestive glaucoma. In examination, we can notice presence of shallow anterior chamber, and gonioscopy shows a variable degree of angle closure. In this photo, we can notice an optic disc changes caused by primary angle closure glaucoma chronic type, and by gonioscopy we can notice shallow angle. Treatment here for chronic angle closure glaucoma by laser iridotomy if most of the angle is open, and trabeculectomy in severe cases of angle closure to bypass the angle. Signs of both congestive angle closure glaucoma. There are many signs which means that this eye had suffered from attack of angle closure glaucoma. It includes folds in distal membrane like this photo due to rise of the IOB and to a high degree then decrease. The rise of the IOB will cause corneal edema and the stretching of the distal membrane. When the IOB reaches to its normal level, we will notice the presence of folds in this membrane. The second sign is presence of osteocyanicae and fine pigments of the iris due to some sort of inflammation which occurred in these cases. Also, the third sign we can notice presence of stromal iris atrophy and spiral-like configuration of the pupil. Here it is caused by severe iris ischemia, which lead to stromal iris atrophy. Due to atrophy of the iris, the pupil will take a spiral-like configuration like this. The fourth sign is fixed dilated pupil due to severe iris ischemia, together with what is called glaucomoflaccin. Glaucomoflaccin is anterior subcapsular lens opacity present on the anterior capsule caused by lens epithelial cells and cortical fibers infarction and necrosis due to high intraocular pressure during attack. We should mention that glaucomoflaccin is a pseudomonic sign for previous attack of angle closure glaucoma acute type. Plateau Ayer syndrome, it is the second mechanism by which angle closure occurs. It includes narrowing of the anterior chamber angle due to insertion of the iris anterior, like this photo. We can notice that the iris inserted anteriorly on the ciliary body or by displacement of the ciliary body itself anterior. In these cases, we can notice that there is normal anterior chamber depth, no shallow anterior chamber like in the pupillary block mechanism of primary angle closure glaucoma. The treatment here not by YAG laser iridotomy, but by argon laser peripheral iridoplasty. We apply different argon laser beam to the peripheral iris. This laser beam will lead to contraction of the iris and pulling of the root of the iris from the angle, and here we can open the angle and avoid the occurrence of angle closure attacks. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy my presentation. Thank you very much.